Hello, my dear students. I welcome you to today's lecture. Today we are going to start with chapter 12, area of circles. Areas of circle. And actually the first exercise hardly has any really strong basics that we require. Actually, we are already good with the basics. They are sufficient enough. What are the basics that we require is actually very simple. Diameter is always double of the radius. Radius is always half of the diameter. Circumference of circle, formula for circumference of circle. Is 2 pi r. And area of circle. Pi r square. I think this much is more than sufficient as per the basics are required, especially for exercise 12.1. And afterwards, apart from that, what is required is only sheer common sense, nothing more than that. So I hope you all have got your textbooks with you, and we will start with exercise 12.1. In first question, they are telling us the radii of two circles are 19 centimeter and 9 centimeter. So here we can consider that radii of two circles are 19 centimeter and 12 centimeter. They have given R1 is equal to 19 centimeter and R2 is equal to 9 centimeter. This is what they have given us. Find the radius of the circle which has circumference equal to the sum of the circumferences of the two circles. Let R be the radius of new circle. Okay. Now C1 is equal to 2 pi R1. C2 is equal to, because they have told that the new circle is actually formed after find the radius of the circle which has circumference equal to the sum of the circumference of the two circles. Okay, whatever is the this circle which has got 19 centimeter, which has got 9 centimeter, whatever is the circumference of this circle, means we will have to open this. Circumference means we will have to open this, and we will also have to open this. These two, when I will join this line and this line, when I will join, and this will be the new circumference, and I will have to make the circle, this circle, new. Okay, I will open this circle, I will get a circle, length of this circle, I will get a length of this circle. When I join these two lines, then that will be my new circle formed. And I have to find the radius of this new circle. So first I should know what is the circumference of this circle. To know the length of this circle, I should know the circumference of this circle, which is actually 2 pi R1. I should also know the length of this circle. When I break it from here, the length of this circle is also going to be 2 pi R2, because formula for circumference of the circle is 2 pi R. When I use this 2 pi R, the R over here is R1. R over here is R2, so that I will have to write R1, 2 pi R1 and 2 pi R2. When I will add this both, this addition will be the circumference of this new circle. That is what is the logic behind this. Now, C is equal to 2 pi R1 plus 2 pi R2. This is given. So I'll take 2 pi as a common factor over here. This will make R1 plus R2. If you want, you can substitute the values of R1 and R2 over here and find the circumference of the new circle, but we are actually not interested really, because they have not asked you to find the circumference of the new circle. We'll just see whether I can find R directly. Now this is circumference I have been given by, in the relation with this two radius, this is going to be the circumference. Okay, this is the circumference according to the question. The condition they have told, circumference of the new circle is going to be 2 pi R1 plus R2. But by formula, we know circumference is going to be 2 pi r. By this formula itself. If I use this formula 2 pi r1 in circle 1, if I use this formula in this circle 1, the formula for circumference is 2 pi r. Try to understand, the formula for circumference is 2 pi r. If this formula I use in this circle with radius r1, it is 2 pi r1. If the same formula I use in this circle where radius is r2, the circumference will become 2 pi r2. And if in this formula I use where the radius is r, so it will be 2 pi r. So basically, but these two are going to be same because circumference of the same circle. So here from 1 and 2, 2 pi r is going to be equal to 2 pi r1 plus r2. Now you can see I take 2 pi over here, 2 pi is a coefficient over here, it will go and divide over here. Because this is multiplying with the bracket, therefore this cancellation is possible. R will be equal to r1 plus r2. R will be equal to, what is r1? 19 plus 9. So r will be equal to 28 centimeter. Okay, my dear student, so with this we have got the first question done, and let's move to question number 2. So if we go to question number 2, what is question number 2? The radii of two circles are 8 centimeter and 6 centimeter respectively. Find the radius of the circle having area equal to the sum of the areas of two circles. It is same. Initially what happened, they did the circumference, they added the circumference over here. The area, this is, these are again the two circles. Again we are dealing with two circles. R1 is equal to 8 centimeter. R2 is equal to 6 centimeter. But now they are taking a new circle. This is supposing 8 centimeter. This is supposing 6 centimeter. Now they are using this area. They are using this area and they are using this area and adding the two areas to make a new circle. Fine. So area of this circle by formula, by area of the circle by formula is pi r square. So here I have taken radius as r1. The area of this circle will be pi r1 square, because instead of r I will use r1. Here it will be pi r2 square, because here the radius is r2 and I will take this radius as r. Actually, according to the question information given, the this area is going to be what? Sum of these areas, means pi r1 square plus pi r2 square. But this actually is going to be equal to pi r square, because the radius is r square. These two are going to be equal. It is same like that only. So here I will tell area 1 is equal to pi r1 square. Area of second circle is equal to pi r2 square. Let r be the radius of circle formed. Therefore, area is equal to a1 plus a2. A is equal, according to the given condition, according to given, this is according to given information, area of circle is going to be area 1 plus area 2, that will be equal to pi r1 square plus pi r2 square. This is according to the given information. But we know by formula area is equal to pi r square, which actually will be applicable to the new circle. From 1 and 2, what will we get? That this is equal to this. That means the pi r square will be equal to pi r1 square plus pi r2 square. Here again what I'll do, I'll take out common factor. Here to no common factor, but here definitely pi and pi will get out as a common factor. Now pi will be shifted over here. So pi will get cancelled, and then I will get r square is equal to r1 square is going to be r1 square plus r2 square. What is r1? 8 square. This is 6 square. 64. We get r is equal to 10 centimeter over here. That's what we have got that. Okay, fine. So now we go to the next question. We require some more papers. Let me arrange for the papers first, my dear students. So always happens with me. I don't know why do I have those slippery hands. Okay, now going to the question number third. So here they have told, here there is a circle given to us, my dear students. In total there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 circles. So, but I think I will not draw all the 5 together, because all the 5 together, if I draw in this, it will really create a lot of confusion there. So I'll draw also, I'll draw that also in a next paper, because see, first I'll draw. This is the smallest circle they have given. First, I will draw 2 circles. Fine. This is, I suppose, the gold circle, okay? This is the gold circle. And then the next circle is red circle. So I will draw at this time, I'll just draw gold and red, nothing other than that, okay? Because one at a time, and then I'll be able to explain you properly, and you also will be able to visualize things properly. So in this question, what are they saying? See now, dear students, this is gold circle and this is red circle. But now let us go step by step. What are they saying is that this depicts an archery target marked with its 5 scoring rings regions from the center outwards as gold, red, blue, black and white. The diameter of the region representing gold circle, now here this diameter is equal to 21 centimeter. I will be interested in finding only the radius. Okay, the radius of gold will be actually 21 divided by 2, 10.5. And each of the other band is 10.5 centimeter. Try to understand. Each of the other band means this band, this region, the width of the band is 10.5. That means this width is going to be 10.5. This width is going to be 10.5. Okay, that is what there is. This is going to happen for each and every band. Find the area of each of the 5 scoring regions. When we have to find the area, means actually when we find the area of the gold, so we will find the area of the gold. So this is the region where anybody can score for gold. But when we have to find the area of red, then only this area we have to find. Here, 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 here. We are not supposed to find the area of gold. Area of red is only this. And it is basically not a circle. It is a ring. You can consider it is a ring with the width 10.5 centimeter. So we have to find the area of this ring. And of course, remember always area of this ring will be what? Area of the ring will always be whatever is the area of the outer circle. This is the area of the outer circle and this is the area of the inner circle. When from the outer circle, whatever is the area of the outer circle, when you subtract the area of the inner circle, this area you subtract, this area you remove, automatically what remains is this area. Try to understand this. You have to remove this area. Means you have to just think that, feel that I have cutting this. With scissors, if I have cut this area out, So what will remain is the area of that ring, means the area of the red circle, red ring. Okay, so you can consider it that way. That is basic concept, that every time when you have to find the area of the ring, then you have to find the area of that whole circle minus the area of the inner circle, whichever is the inner circle sitting over there. Okay, so now let's start with gold. For gold there is no ring as such. For area of golden circle, when it comes to find area of the golden circle, golden scoring area, area of gold scoring area, we can say gold scoring area, golden region. So basically that is equal to now for gold circle, gold circle diameter they have given is 21 centimeter, therefore radius will be equal to 21 upon 2 10.5 centimeter. Now we know area of circle is equal to pi r square. You can label this one, this is area of circle, therefore area of gold circle is equal to pi 22 upon 7, r is 10.5 into 10.5, so this will divide over here, 7 1 the 7 0.5, so this answer will be 22 into 10.5 into 1.5. so if I go to find this, it will become 105 into 22 210 into 15 again, three, four, six, five, zero, but then there are two decimal places, so that will become is equal to 346.5 centimeter will be the area of gold circle. Therefore area of gold scoring region is equal to 346.5 centimeter square. Find this, we have found. Now we go to the other area. Other one is basically now going to be the red scoring region. So red scoring region, so we can find here area of circle. Now see, the outer area is going to be what? The circle is, outer circle is going to be the area of the circle, red and gold color circle, area of red and gold color circle, this is the outer one, minus the area of gold circular region, that will give you the area of the red ring. Try to understand, this is the concept that we have to use. But now my words may be sounding confusing because I am using the time trying to use a perfect phrase. When I talk about this full region, outer circle, here what is the outer circle? Do I call it red circle? No, red circle is only this part. This is not a circle, this is the red ring. So I will have to tell area of circle, red and gold color circle. This will be the full area, will be what? Area of red and gold color circle minus area of gold circle. Well, that's why I am using that phrase. So here, red plus gold color circle. When I talk about red plus gold color circle, now radius is going to be equal to what? R is going to be equal to, see, this is the radius of the gold circle, plus I will have to add this, which is 10.5. I know it is 10.5. This is what? Radius of this is 10.5. This is 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 21 centimeter is going to be the radius of the full circle. Now I should label this as R G karna acha rahega. This will be R G. Okay. So here R, no, this is red plus gold color circle. R R. Okay, R R. Now what I'll tell, area of gold scoring region is equal to area of red plus gold circle minus area of gold circle. When I subtract the two, then I will get the area of gold scoring region. Area of red plus gold scoring region will be pi R R square. I am not taking R1, R2, R3. That will be again confusing. Minus pi R G square. Radius of gold circle. Radius of gold plus red circle. Okay. That when I subtract the two, then I will get the area of gold scoring region. Pi will get out. RR square is basically 21 square, and the area of this gold circle is 10.5 square. So this is equal to 22 upon 7. This I can write as 21 a square minus sorry my dear students, I'm very sorry. We know that area of our a square minus b square is equal to 21 plus 10.5 into 21 minus 10.5. We know that a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. This is the formula that we know. So according to that formula, I'm solving this. So next year we will get 22 upon 7 into this 21 plus 10.5 will give me 31.5 into 21 minus 10.5 will give me 10.5. Therefore, area of red scoring region, if I go to subdivide this 7, 4s are 28, 29, 30, 31, 7, 5s are 35, 22 into 4.5 into 10.5. So if I go to multiply them, so here ...22 into 4.5 ...90, and this also will be 90. This will give me 990 into 10, which is 105. 5 zeros of 0, 5 nines are 45, 9s are 45, 49. Okay, one more is gone. 100, 19s are 9, 19s are 9. 059. 1039.50. This will be equal to 1039.5 centimeter square. This will be the area of red scoring region. Okay, my dear students. So with this, we have finished with area of red scoring region. Now the next will be what they have given us, blue scoring region. So when we go for blue scoring region, again what will happen is, my dear students, that if I draw this region, see, this is going to be the blue region. So now what will happen, again, now what is the outer? Similarly here, see, there is gold, there is red, and there is blue scoring region. So gold, red, blue, all this, this is the area of blue red gold circle, blue red gold circle minus area of red gold circle. This you have to understand. This is going to be now giving you the blue circular region. So now finding area of blue gold, no, blue circular region, blue scoring region. You are going to find area of blue scoring region. This you are going to find now. So area of blue plus, I'm very sorry dear students, blue plus red plus gold circle, radius of blue circle means up to blue you are going to take will be 10.5. now see here, 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 10.5 means plus 10.5 plus 10.5. so red radius of the blue up to blue circle, actually we are labeling it R. This will be equal to, if you multiply by 3 5s are 15, 3 1s are 3, that will be 31.5. okay, fine, that will be 31.5 centimeter. This is gone. That will be the radius of the blue scoring region. Now area of blue plus red plus gold circle will be pi r b square. Fine. Now area of blue scoring region will be equal to area of blue plus gold plus red circle minus area of, what was that, red and gold circle, red plus gold circle. I hope you all are getting this. Now from here, area of blue plus red plus gold circle minus area of, this is red one, we did this red and gold circle. When I subtract this, what will stay will be only this blue scoring region. So that will be equal to pi r b square minus pi r square. Pi will get out, r b square minus r square. So this will be 22/7 r b square. I have got 31.5 square minus r r square, I had got 21. Okay, r r square was 21. Yes, r r square was 21 square. So again here what I'll do, 22/7 into 31.5 plus 21 into 31.5 minus 21. Okay, so if I go to solve this, if I add this, I will get 31 52.5 into, if I subtract this, I'll get 5.10.5. fine. Fine. So now if I go to 49 50 50 50, yes, this I can divide, 7 7 is 49 0.5 is 35. So I get over here 22 into 7.5 into 10.5. this I have to multiply and then I should get the into 7.5 150 150 1650, okay, into again 1650 into 105. Five zero the zero, five five the 25, five is the 30, 31, 32, five the 5 6 7 8. These two times it will go, and then I'll get 0 5 1 6. 0 5 2 8 9 10 11 12 13 7 1 7 3 2 5, two decimal places. This will be equal to 1732.5 centimeter square will be the area of the blue scoring region. Fine. Now similarly we will go to find the area of the next one is black scoring region. Now I will be more precise. Finding area of black scoring region. So here what we will have to do is now here what we'll have to do is that I'll have to add one more circle. This will be now black scoring region. Okay. So in short, what do I have to do over here? The area of, first I have to circle. What circle is that? Gold plus red plus blue plus black. So here, gold plus red plus blue plus black circle. I am dealing with this radius. What I will tell, R L is equal to what now? See this, 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 10.5, means 1, 2, 3, 4 times 10.5. 10.5 into 4. 4, 5 is at 20, 4, 0, 0, 2, 4 and the 42 centimeter will be the area of radius of this full. 10.5 plus 10.5, 21. Here again 21 plus 21, 42 centimeter you will get, will be the area of this full circle, this full circle. And actually area, now here, area of black scoring region will be equal to area of gold plus red plus blue plus black circle minus area of red plus blue plus no gold gold circle. From here I will have to do, see, try to understand whatever what I've got, this gold, then this red, then this blue, and the last one is black. This one is black. Gold, red and blue. So from this full black, blue, red, gold circle, I have to subtract what? Gold, red and blue. This when I will subtract, then automatically what will remain is the black circle. Gold plus blue plus red, I missed gold, subtract this, and this is going to be pi r l square, this whole I have taken as l square, minus pi r, what did I take that, b square. So that will be pi r l square, I got it as 42 square, and r b square I had got it as, see here, RB I had got it as 31.5 square. 31.5 square. Of course, but what will I do over here? 22 upon 7 into 42 plus 31.5 and 42 minus 31.5. So what will I get? 22 upon 7 into, if I add this 73.5 into, if I subtract this 2, this is going to be slightly different. 42 minus 31.5, 0, 4 minus 3, 10.5 into 10.5, 7, 1, 7, 0, point, yes, 7, 1, 7, 0.5. So this will give me 22 into 10.5 into 10.5. This is actually easy. See, anything multiplied by 105 into 105. See, when we find the square of 75 square, will be after 7 what it is? After 7 the number is 8. Number after 7 is 8. 7, 8 is 56, and then you have to write 25 in front of it. Okay? 85, square of 85 will be 8. After 8 is what? 9. 8, 9 is 72, and then 25 you have to write. So after 10, it is what? 11. 10, 11 is 110, and then 25 you have to write. That will be the square of 105. Means 10.5 into 10.5 will be 110, 25. And then you have to multiply this by 22 also. 2, 5 is 10, 2, 2 is 4, 5, 0. 2, 1 is 2, 2, 1 is 2. This will be again 0, 5, 0, 2, 2. 5242. This will be the answer of this. Hopefully this should be right, otherwise then I have done some mistake. No, but this is right. So this will be equal to 2425.50 centimeter square. This is the therefore area of black scoring region is equal to 2425.50 centimeter square. Okay, and then we have to go to find the last one, I suppose, white scoring region. Finding area of white scoring region. So again, now I don't think I have to do this fair work again with the help of compass and everything. You can understand it like this also. Now see what all the areas that I have got. Area of gold, red, blue, black, and then white. These many I have got. What are they? Gold, red, blue, black, white. That means now finding area of here, circle with white plus black plus blue plus red plus gold circle. Radius I will take this as what now? RW, because I am going to treat up to white. Is going to be what? See, this is 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 10.5 plus 10. How many 10.5? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10.5 will be 10.5 into 5. 5 5s are 25, 5 are 5, and then 1 0. This will be 52.5 centimeter will be the radius of this full white circle. But then area of white scoring region is equal to area of white plus black plus blue plus red plus gold circle minus area of white should be ignored, and whatever is remaining, this you have to subtract. And what will stay is only the white. Area of black plus blue plus red plus gold circle. Therefore, area of white scoring region is equal to pi r w square minus pi r l square. That will become pi r w square minus r l square. That will be 22/7. R w I have got it as 52.5 square. R l I had got that as 42 square. Again here 22/7, 52.5 plus 42 into 52.5 minus 42. So this will give me 22/7. 52.5 plus 42 will give me 94.5. This addition will give me 94.5, and this subtraction will give me, it had given me first, now I had done that. 52.5 minus 42. Okay. 10.5. So this will give me 7 5 are 35. So I get what? 22 into 13.5 into 10.5. This I will have to multiply. So here I get 135 into 22, 170, this also will be 170, 1870, and then again 105, 500, 57, 35, 58, 40, 3, 5, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, 7, 8, 1, 5, 3, 9, 196, 3, 5, 0, 2 decimal places. This is not right. How can this be? 7 1 7 8 9. This is right. This cannot be the condition, my dear students, because it has to go more. 135 into 22. 2 5 are 10 2 3 are 6 7 2 1 are 2 2 5 are 10 2 3 are 6 7 2 1 are 2. 270 is going to be over here. 0792970 into 105 57 35 59 45 46 47 48 5 2 10 11 12 13 14. This will be again 0 0 1 7 the 7 1 9 are 9 1. 2s are 2, 0, 5, 8, 11, 19, 11. This is going to be 3118.50. This is right. 3118.5 centimeter square. This is the area of white scoring region, my dear students. Okay. So with this, we have finished the huge long question. Question number 3. Okay, now let's go to solve question number 4. It was lengthy definitely, but I think those questions are actually for your making your fundamentals strong. Here this question is also of the same sort. The wheels of a car are of a diameter 80 centimeter. So I am talking about wheel of car, diameter is equal to 80 centimeter. Therefore, radius is equal to 40 centimeter. How many complete revolution does each wheel make in 10 minutes when the car is traveling at the speed of 66 kilometer per hour? See, my dear students, when they are talking about this question, what we have to understand is, see, they are talking about the wheel and the speed and the distance covered. See, one thing first of all, now there are two three basics that you have to understand. First basic is what is the connection of the wheel, in what way is this wheel connected to the ground, what is the relation of the wheel with the ground? See, it is nothing like that. One thing you have to remember, circumference of the wheel will always be equal to distance covered by wheel in one rotation. I hope you all are getting. See, because when this is the point of the wheel, if this is in touch, the wheel will rotate and come back at that point. That will be actually nothing but the circumference of the wheel. This border of the wheel, whatever is the length of the border, that will be actually the distance that the wheel has covered in one rotation. So always the circumference is equal to the distance covered by the wheel in one rotation. This is the relation. In one time, whenever the wheel will rotate one time, then on the ground, distance traveled will be whatever is the circumference of the wheel. This you have to understand first. Now try to understand. This you have to keep it in mind and clearly understand. Circumference of the wheel, whatever is the circumference of the wheel, I have to measure the circumference of the wheel. Why? Because when I measure the circumference of the wheel, then only I will come to know what is the distance that wheel is traveling in one rotation on the ground. Now they are telling the wheel actually is traveling with the speed of, this is one, speed of the wheel is how much? 66 kilometer per hour. Try to understand, per hour. And they are asking us, the third they are asking is actually the third terminology, we have to understand what is the distance it will travel in 10 minutes. In 10 minutes. See, distance traveled will be equal to one circumference. In one rotation, how much distance he has traveled? One circumference. To know what is the distance he has traveled in 10 minutes. In one rotation, he will travel. See, try to understand what I am telling. I know it is slightly confusing for, it may be slightly confusing for some students. See, what I am trying to explain is that, see, if it is, supposing the circumference of the wheel, supposing, let us take it to be 100 centimeters, 1 meter. That means on the ground, when the wheel will turn once, when the wheel will turn once and reach over here, once, then on the ground the wheel has traveled 100 centimeter. That's what I mean to say. This will be the distance traveled by the wheel once, when once it will rotate. If this same wheel, which is actually 100 centimeter, when it travels and rotates two times, that means from here to here he has traveled 100 centimeter, again from here to here, that means it totally has traveled two circumferences, not two times. If he has taken rotation five times, that means what is the distance traveled by it? Five circumferences. 5 into circumference. What is the circumference? 100. 500 centimeter he will be traveling. Try to understand this. Which with each added rotation, one more circumference is getting on added. So now if I know the number of rotations the number of rotation the wheel has taken, if I know how many rotation he has taken, I will be able to tell what is the distance he has traveled on the ground, provided I know how many rotation he has taken. Because on each rotation he will be traveling distance equal to the circumference, in this case 100. I should know only how many rotations he has taken. So in 10 minutes, okay, fine, he is traveling for 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, whatever he is traveling, I should know number of rotations he has taken. Okay, I should know number of rotations he has taken. Now considering, or the distance he has traveled. Okay, number of rotations he has taken, or the distance he has traveled. I can go in this way also. Even if the distance is traveled is 100 centimeter, that means the circumference is 100 centimeter. Ulta also I can go, whatever it is, let us go in this way. The number of rotations he has, I have to understand. If I know the number of rotation, that many circumferences is the distance traveled. Okay, Now he is traveling with the speed of 66 km per hour, means 66,000 meters in 1 hour, means 60 minutes. But this is meter, I want it in centimeter. 66,000 and one more 100 centimeter in 60 minutes. This many distance, this much distance he is traveling, this much distance he is traveling in 60 minutes. 66 kilometer is traveling in 60 minutes. That means 66,000 meter is traveling in 60 minutes. That means 66,100 centimeter is traveling in 60 minutes. I am not interested in this. I want in 10 minutes what distance he will travel. In 10 minutes he will travel 66,100 into 10, and 60 will come and divide over here. This much will be the distance traveled by him, by the wheel, in 10 minutes. In this is the distance traveled in 10 minutes. Are you getting? So once I know this is the distance traveled by him in this many minutes. Okay, so now this is the distance traveled by him. What is the distance? 66,100 into 10 upon 60. This is the distance traveled by him in that many minutes. And what is they have given? I can find the circumference. So how many revolutions he must have taken? See now, what is the number now? Circumference into number of revolution is equal to distance traveled. So this is what we should know. Circumference into number of revolutions is equal to distance traveled. Circumference into number of revolutions is equal to distance traveled. I hope you all are getting this. How many ever revolutions you take, how many ever rotation is take, multiply that by the number of revolution, how many, the number of revolution into circumference, multiply that by the circumference, and that will be the distance traveled. At this moment you know the distance traveled, you know the circumference. Number of revolution will be equal to what? Distance traveled upon circumference. That will give you the number of revolutions. Are you getting, my dear students? Do I have to explain it once more if anything is confusing? One more try. I know it's going to be lengthy. Those who have understood can actually move forward. One who have not understood can take one more explanation. Try to understand, my dear students. Whatever is the circumference, whatever is the circumference, I am taking the circumference as 100. This is 100 circumference. It moves once. The distance traveled will be 100 centimeter. It moved, the wheel rotated thrice, one, two, thrice it rotated. So 100, second 100, third 100, the distance traveled will be 300. It is basically nothing but 3 into circumference. Number of rotation into circumference will give you distance traveled. Try to understand, number of rotations into circumference. Every time, even if supposing he has taken 10 rotations like this, 10 rotation, the distance traveled will be equal to what? 10 into circumference means 100. That will be equal to 1000 centimeter. What are you doing? Number of rotation into circumference is giving you distance traveled. So when you are solving this, you have seen that circumference you know, because they have given you the diameter, they have given the 2 pi r, because radius is 40. Circumference you know, even number of rotations you don't know, but distance traveled you have known. Distance traveled is basically what? 66 kilometer per hour. So 66 kilometer per 60 minutes, because 1 hour is 60 minutes. That means 66 1000 meter in 60 minutes. That means 66,100 centimeter in 60 minutes. And how in 10 minutes how many he will find? 66,000. Did I misplace that? I will show it again. 66,100 upon 60 into 10 karega. So you will know that this is the distance traveled in 10 minutes is equal to number of revolution into 2 pi r. Now number of revolution will be what? Come and this and divide it over here. Means distance traveled upon circumference is equal to number of revolution. Okay, so let's try to solve this question. So here they have told us wheel of the car is equal to this. So therefore circumference is equal to 2 pi r. I can keep it like that only because solving Kannadam, that is better to solve at that time together. Let us see. Circumference equal to 2 pi r. So now speed of wheel 66 kilometer per hour. Therefore that is equal to 66,000 meter in 60 minutes. Therefore distance traveled in 10 minutes. See now what I am doing. 1000 centimeter bhi chahiye tha. 66,100 centimeter in 60 minutes because our wheel is in centimeter. 66,100 in 60 minutes. This is distance time. So what is the distance he has traveled in 10 minutes? Cross multiply 66,100 into 10 is equal to x into 60. 60 will then come and divide over here is equal to 66,100 upon 60 into 10 centimeter. Again this will be distance traveled by him. 6 11 1 2 3 4 into 10, that will be again 1 2 3 4 5 centimeter in 10 minutes. Okay, now you will tell number of revolution is equal to distance traveled divided by circumference. Distance traveled is 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Circumference 2 pi r upon 2 pi r. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 upon 2. Radius is 40. 22 upon 7, I will write it inverted. 7 upon 22. Now this is very easy to 11 ones are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 divided by 2. 101. Now again 4, 25 is 100 and then 2 more zeros. 2, 1s are 2, 2s are 4, 5s are 10 and then 1 more 0. This is gone, nah? 2, 6 are 12, 2s are 4, 5s. 6, 25 into 7. 7, 5s are 35, 7 is a 14, 15, 16, 17, 7, 6 are 42, 43, 4, 3, 7, 5 revolutions. He must have, the wheel must have taken, just let me confirm this. Yes, 4, 3, 7, 5 revolutions. The wheel must have taken, my dear students. So, I've tried my best to give the explanation of this working. And now let us see the question number 5. Tick the correct answer in the following and justify your choice. If the perimeter and the area of a circle are numerically equal, perimeter and area of a circle of, then radius of the circle is what? See, perimeter of circle is basically circumference of a circle 2 pi r. Okay, perimeter of a circle and the area of circle. Area of circle is equal to pi r square. They are telling these two are equal. That means 2 pi r is equal to pi r square, right? Circumference is this, area is this. Now if I go to solve this, r is equal to, which one I take where? Okay, well, there are two r's over here, 2 pi r, pi r into r. So I take this pi r over there, 2 pi r upon pi r. I want only one r na here. I take this pi r over there, will be equal to r. So pi r se pi r mar gaya. R is equal to 2. The radius is equal to 2 units. This is your right answer. Okay, this is possible when the radius is equal to 2 units. Then the circumference and the area of the circle will be same. Okay, my dear students, so with this we have finished the exercise 12.1. Soon we will start with exercise 12.2, my dear students. Okay, stay home, stay safe, and most importantly, my dear students, stay happy. See you all soon. Bye for now.